How to recondition a Welbond high pressure stop valve by Yarway. Reconditioning a Welbond high pressure stop valve is a simple operation, one that saves time, money, and it can be done in line. Reconditioning is quick. The actual reseating operation takes no more than an hour. It is done with a simple reseating tool that Yarway provides, and they're available in different sizes to fit all Yarway valves. Caution! Make sure that all line pressure is relieved and that the pipeline is secured against pressurization.
Loose backseat valve.
First, loosen the swing bolts and let them drop out of the way. This allows you to lift up the packing gland. Nuts do not need to be removed from the swing bolts. Swing bolts are long enough to swing with the nuts still on. Next, remove the two halves of the split gland bushing. Inspect them. If they are still in good condition, save them for reassembly. If they are damaged or corroded, replace them. Remove the T-handle. Next, remove the tack weld. You can now unscrew the yoke bushing. Welbond valves come in two basic designs. One that has a loose back seat, the other a fixed back seat. Here we are working with the loose back seat design. By unscrewing the stem and yoke bushing, the packing can be easily removed from the valve. Discard the old packing and replace it with new. Now you are ready to cut a new seat. The Welbond valve seat is a stellite casting, thick enough for the renewal of the seating surface several times over. The valve renewal is not a lapping operation. Instead, the seat cutting tool creates a whole new seating surface. Snap the seat cutting tool together and thread it into the yoke. The tool is inserted through the valve yoke. You should hand tighten the feed screw until the cutting blade contacts the valve seat. When the cutting heads make contact, tighten the lock knob to prevent the tool from taking progressively deeper cuts into the stellite material. Next, mount the hand wheel. Now you are ready to make one or two slow cutting turns. Each turn is a complete revolution of the hand wheel. When the wheel turns freely, readjust the lock knob so that you can make a new cut. The tool cuts both the incline portion and throat of the seat to make a completely new line seal. It eliminates the time-consuming practice of lapping or grinding. After five or six careful turns, remove the tool and visually inspect the new seat surface. You can do this fairly easily on small valves by using a flashlight. You should see a shiny surface completely free of blemishes. This indicates that the seat has been fully and evenly restored to its original factory condition. If you're going to have to make some additional cuts, just reinsert the tool and give it one or two more complete turns and check the seat again to make sure it has been restored. A bit of bluing compound on the face of the new disc and seat assembly will allow you to check for a good disc to seat engagement. This is especially recommended for smaller valves or where visual inspection is difficult. Incidentally, we recommend the installation of a new stem disc assembly or one that has been reconditioned in the shop. Insert the stem disc assembly into the valve and screw in the yoke bushing for alignment. Close the valve tightly as if you were reassembling it. Then unscrew the stem and remove the yoke bushing. A continuous line will ridge around the face of the disc, showing that a perfect seating surface has been cut. If you find any gaps in the line revealed in the bluing process, the restoration is not complete, and you'll have to make another cut. Now you are ready to reassemble. Please follow the steps shown ahead. Insert the stem disc assembly into the valve. If you need to replace the stem disc assembly, it is available as a spare part by Yarway. Install the new packing. Insert the split gland bushing and turn it 90 degrees. Position the swing bolts and tighten the yoke bushing. Pin or re-tack the yoke bushing. Install the T-handle and tighten the swing bolts. Now let's go through the steps for reconditioning a Welbond valve with the fixed backseat design. For demonstration purposes, we've turned this valve into a fixed backseat model. Such a conversion is easy because both valves use the same body with internal backseat threads. You can start off the same way as before by loosening the swing bolts. The packing gland is lifted, so you can remove the split gland bushing. Next, you can remove the tack weld so you can unscrew the yoke bushing. A fixed backseat valve is identifiable by a letter B after the number on the valve identity plate, or by a B stamped on the yoke top face. A special tool is used to remove the packing and get to the valve's permanent backseat. This packing cutter is inserted along the stem until it comes to rest against the packing. Next, the tool guide is inserted over the packing cutter and screwed into the yoke threads. These tools are all supplied as part of the kit for renewing valves. The guide is inserted into the yoke until the holes of the guide and the cutter are lined up. The pry bar is inserted into the holes. Now the packing cutter can be screwed into the valve packing. When the cutter can no longer turn freely, it has become filled with the packing material. You can now back out the tool. You will probably have to use the cutter one or two more times to remove all the packing from the valve. Remove the packing support ring. This can be done by using a stiff wire with a hook on the end. With the cutting tool guide removed and all the packing out of the valve, you can now get to the permanently installed backseat. The backseat removal tool has two doll gears, which fit into the two slots on the backseat. The guide is again used, and it is screwed on until the holes on both tools line up. By turning the pry bar counterclockwise, the backseat is unscrewed out of the body. Once in a while, you may have a backseat that needs some persuasion. In this case, apply some heat with a torch. The sudden expansion of the part will break the buildup around the threads, and the backseat will now turn freely. You can now remove the guide, the backseat removal tool, and the stem disc assembly out of the valve's body. You should also remove the packing gland. The valve seat is now ready to be reconditioned. It is done the same way as on the loose backseat valve. Just snap the seat cutting tool together and thread it onto the yoke. Through a series of careful turns, you restore the valve seating surface to a factory new condition. After you determine that the seat has been restored, reassemble the valve. For fixed backseat designs, the procedure goes like this. Insert the stem and disc assembly. Using the backseat removal tool and the guide, thread the backseat and tighten firmly. Remove the backseat removal tool and drop in the packing support ring. Install new packing. Insert the split gland bushing and turn it 90 degrees. Position the swing bolts and tighten the yoke bushing. Pin or re-tack the yoke bushing. Install the T-handle and tighten the swing bolts. And there you have it, a fully restored Welbond valve. There's no pipe preparation, insulation removal, lapping, specialized welding, or radiography involved. You can do it in an hour or less with just one person. It is helping companies keep costs down and productivity up. These days, that's really important. And with Welbond valves from Yarway, it's a lot easier.